Okay, start Dah 24, dalam 40 minit. Okay, bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi ta'ala wabarakatuh. Okay, so we continue with our next topic on chi-square. Okay, so this is, this chi-square is a non-parametric analysis Okay, if let's say you are, your data does not meet the requirement of normality or you have data that is based on frequency, you may consider this analysis to run to answer your research objective. Okay, so this is the LO, okay, the learning outcome. Kenapa tak nampak ni? Okay, so in this topic, you will learn on the three types of chi-square. Okay, there are three, actually there are a few types of chi-square, but the main types are three. So but in this topic we just cover two. Okay, so chi-square goodness of fit and chi-square test of independence. Another one is test of homogeneity. We are not going to cover that topic. Okay, so the second one is the assumption in chi-square test. Okay, and then the third one, analysis and interpretation of chi-square analysis results, and lastly about reporting, reporting the result according to the psychological association style. Okay, we proceed to the general introduction of the chi-square. Sebenarnya saya tak tahu kenapa ni. Saya ni hang. Chi-square is related to the so chi-square is a type of analysis that depend on only one parameter, which is the degree of freedom. Okay, so chi-square it's only depend on degree of freedom. Okay, so the shape of the distribution to the right, in which all chi-square value will always be positive. Okay, if let's say we refer to the graph, the graph will always skew to the right side. Okay, and then if you have a small sample size or small degree of freedom somehow reflect your sample size lah. Okay. So the smaller the degree of freedom, okay, the more skewed your graph or your data. Okay, and then if let's say you have the larger large sample size, okay, your graph will be more symmetric. Okay? Okay, and then the entire chi-square distribution lies to the right of the y-axis, and then the chi-square distribution assumes non-negative value because chi-square all the values will only be positive. Okay? So if let's say this is saya try nak tunjuk slideshow takut jadi. Okay, this is the illustration for chi-square distribution. If you have the degree of freedom 2 or perhaps this your sample size is 3. Okay, so this is how your chi-square looks like. Okay, it will skew to the right side. Okay, if you have 7 if you have degree of freedom 7. Okay, this is how the your shape for your data will looks like. Okay, and then this is for degree of freedom 12. Okay, so the larger the sample size or the larger the degree of freedom, your the tendency of your graph to be symmetric. Okay, be.
Ayah. Aduh, hai.
Jangan marah, siapa tu?
Sabar Syawal.
Syawal ke Syarul? Syarul tu.
Oh, Syarul lah, Syarul. Oh, okay. Kena Syarul
lah. Kau mute lah.
Ya Allah, ya Allah.
Sabar, Rul.
Ya, marah, Rul.
Sini terkawal.
Saya pula yang takut. Okay. Okay. Okay, so there are three types. If you still remember when you attend this ERS 5950 classes for Bahaman covered three types of chi-square. Okay, but in this topic I just cover two: goodness of fit and test of independence. Okay, good. Chi-square goodness of fit. It's really we use this one. Okay, when we are interested to test certain assumption on the distribution of a categorical variable. Okay, so in this case, the scale of measurement for the variable is categorical. It is either nominal or ordinal. Okay, and then meanwhile for the test of independence, okay, we are interested to test on the association between variables regarding contingency table. Okay, so this one also related to categorical variable as well. Okay, so the first one is chi-square goodness of fit. Okay. So this is the introduction. It has been developed by Carl Pearson in 1980s, and then also known as one sample chi-square test. Okay, this analysis is comparable to one sample t-test. Okay, it is comparable. It just in this case we use the categorical variable. Okay, and then we use frequency data from a sample to test hypothesis about the population proportions. And then we are interested to know on how well the sample data fits the population proportions specified by the null hypothesis. And then the aims is to compare the proposition of cases from a sample in which the actual frequency with hypothesized values or those obtained previously expected from comparison population. So similar to one sample t-test in which we have the earlier data that we obtained from the study being conducted by either by previous researcher, and then we run another analysis, then we compare against the existing value. Okay, so similar the way we conduct one sample chi-square goodness of fit is similar to how we conduct the one sample t-test. Okay, so the purpose is, again, we want to compare the observed and estimated or expected frequencies in each category to test whether all categories have the similar or user-specified proportion of value. Okay, so we want to compare. We have two values of observed and estimated. Then we want to compare with the previous study, either it is similar or different. Okay, for example, we want to have we want to test either 20% of smokers. We want to test either a population, okay, a selected population consists of 20% smokers and then another 80% non-smokers. So this is the hypothesis that we developed based on the previous study, for example. So the requirement is, okay, in this chi-square goodness of fit, we have only one variable. Okay, in which the variable, the number of category of the variable can be larger or equals to 2. This larger or equals to 2. Okay, and then it must be nominal or ordinal. Okay, and then the data in the cells should be frequency or counts. Okay, different with one sample t-test. Okay, our dependent variable is in continuous form. Okay, the scale of measurement for our one sample t-test is either interval or ratio. But for chi-square goodness of fit, our dependent variable is in frequency or counts. Okay. Okay, and then the expected frequencies or each category should appear only once in the data, meaning that it must be mutually exclusive. It is quite similar to two-way ANOVA, okay, in which once the sample appear in one group, it cannot appear in another group. Okay, it must be mutually exclusive. Okay, for the number of group equals to 2, okay, the expected frequency should not be smaller than 5. For more than 20% of the total expected frequency. Okay, this one you shouldn't worry. Later when we go through the example, you will get the clear picture regarding this requirement. Okay, and then for the sample for the small expected frequency case, the binomial test should be used. Okay, so if let's say you have the small sample size, you need to consider the binomial test. Okay, And then for the number of group larger than 2, okay, the expected frequency should not be smaller than 1 for more than 20%. Okay, of the total expected frequency. So it's quite different. And this one we use the cutoff point 5. Okay, for the 20% of the total expected frequency. Meanwhile, for the number of group larger than 2, the cutoff point is 1. Okay. Okay, and then in the case,
doctor,
can
I ask? It's the same. The first one k larger than 2, and the third one k larger 2.
Again,
Lubna.
Okay, sorry, Lubna. Again.
The first one analysis involve one variable only, k larger than 2.
Okay.
That's right. Nominal or it's different.
It's similar.
Number three.
Okay.
Yeah, for k is larger also than 2.
Okay. In chi-square goodness of fit, okay, we have only one variable. Okay, in which variable can either has the 2 groups or more than 2 groups. Okay?
Okay.
So we have only one variable, but inside the variable, okay, the minimum number of level, the minimum number of categories inside the variable can be 2 or more than 2. Okay.
Okay.
So let's say we have only two level or 2 categories inside one variable. Okay, we use the cutoff point 5. Okay, but for number of group larger than 2, we use 1. Okay, I will explain better later regarding how to use this indicator.
Okay.
Okay. So in terms of the assumption, okay, the data should be based on random sample, okay, and then there is no requirement for the shape of data distribution, okay, that meaning that there is no need for you to test the normality distribution as well as the homogeneity of variance, okay. So the only assumption available here is regarding your sample, regarding the random sampling. Okay, so what to expect is similar from the previous topic. Okay, we state the H0 and HA, identify the test statistics or the significant chi-square value from the IBM SPSS output. Okay, and then we set the alpha, we make decision, and lastly, we make the conclusion. Okay. Okay, so this is the 5 steps. Okay, so the step one. Okay, when we are interested to run the chi-square goodness of fit, okay, when we state the null and research hypothesis, our null hypothesis will be the statement of assumption. So what is our assumption regarding our population? And then our research hypothesis will be related to the statement of opposite of the assumption. If, for example, okay, the observed frequencies are equal to the expected frequency, okay? And then our research hypothesis will be the observed frequency are different from the expected frequency. Okay, this is another practical example. Okay, for example, you are interested to know either your respondents are equally happily married or not. Okay, so you come up with the null hypothesis, respondents are equally happy about their married life. Okay, and then perhaps your research hypothesis will be not all respondents are happy about their married life. Perhaps some respondent can be very happy, somewhat happy, or not happy. Okay. So the step two, okay, we extract the significant chi-square value when we run the analysis in IBM SPSS. Okay, are you ready with your data set? Ready? At least someone answer me, please.
Yes,
doctor. Jap.
Yeah. Okay, I'll give you a few minutes. Hari ni sikit je, 2 topik je. So boleh laju lah hari ni.
2 topik?
Ya, sejam pun boleh habis ni. Ready? Saya faham kadang-kadang time. Ready Tadi siapa yang belum buka?
Okay. Yes.
Okay. Run the analysis, okay, you click analyze, click non-parametric test, and then click legacy dialog. Analyze non-parametric test, okay, analyze non-parametric test, legacy dialog, and chi-square. Okay, then after that, Okay, the chi-square test window appear. Okay, from your left side, you choose the hakma. Hakma is related to happy marriage. Okay, hakma. Okay, you select your hakma value, hakma data. Okay, and then, okay, so for this, under the expected value, okay, if you have a certain if your null hypothesis, you state that there is a differences, okay, if there are differences between the observed and expected value, then you may enter the value here, okay, but salah, saya kena mute dulu, risau pula. Okay. So, okay, if you do not have any values, then meaning that earlier in our hypothesis, we just assume that, based on our null hypothesis, we assume that all respondents have a happy marriage. Okay? So, here we just click all categories equal. Okay? In our case, we just click all categories equal. Okay, and then you just click okay. Okay, this is a very simple analysis. Okay, so this is the result of our chi-square goodness of fit. Okay, so the expected n, okay, represent the average score if all categories were equal. So this is what we expect. Okay, this is our expected value. Okay, from our null hypothesis. Okay, and then this is the residual. Okay, the residual is actually the differences between the observed and the expected value. Okay, so based on the observed frequency and the residual, clearly there is a difference between the degree of happiness among the respondent. Okay, so we can see based on the residual indicate the differences between observed and expected. So if let's say you deduct the observed, deduct the expected, you will get this value. So based on the residual, we can see that there are differences, in terms of the degree of happiness among our respondents. Okay. Okay, so the next analysis that we need to refer to is the chi-square and the asymptotic significant value. Okay. So this is the chi-square value, eh? This is the chi-square value, and then this one represents the significant chi-square. Okay, so this one based on the significant value, because the significant value is lesser than alpha, so we can say that we reject H naught. Okay, so we reject H naught. Okay, so earlier I said that if your category consists of 2, okay, the cutoff point is 5, right? So meaning that in this case, 0 cells have expected frequency less than 5. So earlier we said that for the 2 category, for the if your variable consists of 2 category, the minimum is 20%, okay, but less than 5. Okay, but for the variable that consists of more than 2 category, okay, the cutoff point here is still 20%, but expected frequency less than 1. Okay, so here in this case, since there is no expected frequency less than 5, therefore our chi-square value considered to be valid. Okay, so this one, mana dah? Nak balik lama. Okay, so this requirement is actually on how you determine either the result for your chi-square is valid or not. Okay, because if let's say your data the result is not valid or not significant, okay, so we will suggest you to collapse the adjacent categories, okay, to make sure that you come up with the significant result. Okay. So any question regarding chi-square goodness of fit?
Doctor?
Yeah?
Like in this case yang run tadi tu, that is considered more than 2 kan?
Yes, this one so is more than 2. So,
the value should be smaller than 1, betul?
Betul. The value that kita akan gunakan smaller than 1. But here, by default, they will give us 5. Okay, but since, in this case, memang tak ada pun. Okay, so 0 cell have expected frequency less than 5. Okay, so then the minimum expected cell, the minimum is 445. Okay? Kalau kita ada this one less than 5 ni, meaning that even our result might not be significant lah.
Oh, but then yang expected frequency tu boleh set ke doktor jadi 1 ke 5 ke tak?
Tak boleh. By default memang 5.
Okay, alright. Thank you, doktor.
Okay, welcome. Okay. Okay, so we set our alpha. Okay, and then to make decision, there are only two possible decision. Either we reject or fail to reject the null hypothesis. Okay, if we reject the null hypothesis, meaning that our significant value smaller or equal to alpha. If we fail to reject H naught, meaning that our significant chi square larger than alpha. Okay, significant chi square we refer to this table. This one we refer to the asymptotic value here. Here the the frequency table ni just indicate the description. Okay, how much is the differences between the categories? Okay, so in this case, since the significant value, since the significant chi square 0.000 lesser than alpha 0.05, therefore we reject hash naught. Okay, and then therefore we can conclude that because we reject the hash naught, we conclude that not all respondents are equally happy from their marriage, and then the proportion across level of happiness are statistically different. Okay, so perhaps we can propose for the next analysis to determine which categories that are most significant, which groups or which respondents are actually more happy about their married life. Okay. So in terms of APA reporting, okay, it's very simple. A chi-square and goodness of fit test were computed for comparing happiness of marriage, in which one reflect the very happy, 2 pretty happy, 3 not too happy in equal proportion. Okay, statistically significant deviation from the hypothesized equal proportion was found, in which chi-square value degree of freedom 2, degree of freedom for error 1337 equals to 750.7, significant value lesser than alpha. Okay, ini sahaja untuk reporting dia. Okay, in terms of APA table, this is how you should report. This is how the APA table for chi-square goodness of fit looks like. Okay, you report the level, the frequency, the observed and the expected value inside the table, and then you report the chi-square and then the significant chi-square and then the degree of freedom below the table. Okay. So any question? Senang je ni. Okay. So the second one is chi-square test of dependence. Okay. So this one. Okay. The aim is to finding whether the two qualitative variables are independent of each other or related to each other by taking into account the proportion of responses found in the combination of different categories of these two variables. Okay, for this analysis, chi-square test of independence, it is comparable to t-test analysis of independence. Okay, independent t-test. Okay. So it is comparable analysis. Just in this case, the variables are in category. Okay. And then it's also known as a test of association. Okay. And then in which we seek to test the relationship between two categorical variables. Okay. So earlier in our test of independent, the interest is more on comparison. But inside this chi-square test of independence, the interest is more on to look for the association between categorical variables. Okay. Okay, and then the requirement is, okay, the purpose is we want to test the association between two categorical variables and determine the strength of the association. Okay, so this one is also perhaps, not perhaps, it is also a comparable analysis for to look for the association, just like the Pearson product moment correlation and Spearman rank order. Okay, but this one is in categorical. Okay. Okay, in terms of the requirement, both DV and IV must be nominal or ordinal, in which at least one of the variable is nominal scale. So if let's say you have your DV is nominal, okay, your IV can either be nominal or ordinal, but if let's say you have IV ordinal, your DV must be nominal. Okay, either one of your DV or IV must be in nominal scale of measurement. Okay, and then in terms of the calculation, it is based on frequency rather than numerical scores. Okay, so both chi-square, okay, chi-square goodness of fit and then chi-square test of independence, the calculation will rely on the frequency, not the score. Okay, the frequency, meaning that we use the exact values, okay, the whole numbers. Okay, and then in terms of the assumption, there must be at least two categories for each of the two categorical variables. Okay, the minimum number of both category for IV and DV, the minimum must be two. Okay, you can have more, but the minimum is two. Okay, and then in terms of the observation in each group should be independent, and then the expected frequency for each category should appear only once. So similar to chi-square goodness of fit, okay, the frequency or the appearance of your respondents must be mutually exclusive. Okay, once it is already appear in one group, it cannot be appear in another group. Okay, in terms of the sample size, should be large enough to ensure that the expected frequency in each cell is at least one, and then the majority of cell have the expected count of at least five. Okay, then what to expect? Okay, similar. Okay, we test the hypothesis. Okay, state a H0, HA, extract the significant chi-square value after we run the analysis in IBM SPSS. We determine the alpha, we make decision and interpretation. Lastly, present and report. Okay, and then after that, we are going to measure the association between the categorical variables based on either the pi coefficient, contingency coefficient, and Kramer's V coefficient. Pi-square coefficient only applicable for 2x2 contingency table. Okay, meanwhile the rest you can use either for 2x2, 2x3, 3x2 contingency table. Okay, so only for pi coefficient, only applicable for 2x2. Okay, so this is the hypothesis test. Let's skip this one, I'll just skip. Okay, for the first step in terms of the stating the hypothesis for chi-square test of independence, okay, the null hypothesis will be either the two variables are independent of each other, or the research hypothesis will be the two variables are not independent of each other. Okay, so it's actually if let's say it is independent, it is not related lah, but for your research hypothesis you also may state as the two variables is dependent on each other pun boleh. Okay. Okay, so this is the example. There is no association between variable 1 and variable 2 for our null hypothesis, and then for our research hypothesis, there exists an association between variable 1 and variable 2. Or you also missed it as there is a significant association between variable 1 and variable 2. Okay, this is another example. Okay, we use this, we will use the earlier data. Okay, our research null hypothesis is there is no association between happiness of marriage and general happiness. Okay, and then our research hypothesis is there exists an association between happiness of marriage and general happiness. Okay, to run the analysis, again, we use the earlier data set. Okay, are you ready with the data set? At least someone respond, please. Diam semua. Ready, eh? Jim, ready, Jim? Jim je yang nampak video. Okay. To run the analysis, okay, you again. Okay.
Ready.
Okay, beres-beres. Okay, to run the analysis in IBM SPSS, you just click analyze descriptive statistics and cross-tab. Analyze descriptive statistics and cross-tab. Okay, and then you insert the HAPMA, happy marriage on rows. For rows, you choose the HAPMA. Okay, this one, happy marriage. Okay, and then for column, you choose happy. This one is general happiness. Okay, we want to test either the happy marriage will lead to general happiness. Okay. Okay, and then this one, make sure you click the display clustered bar charts. Okay, and then now click statistics. Okay, click statistics. Under statistics, you tick for chi-square, and then under the nominal, you choose pi and Cramer's B, and then click continue. Okay, and then click this one, click cell display. This one, click cells. Okay, this one, click cells. Then after that, you click cells. Okay, under cells, you click observe. Under counts, count here, click tick for observe, expected. Okay, and then for residuals, click unstandardized, non-integer weight, by default round cell counts, and then click continue, and then click okay. Okay, so this is the result.
Betul, laju, repeat.
okay, dah diam je semua. Okay, again eh. Okay, so to run the analysis, we click analyze descriptive statistics and cross-tab. Analyze descriptive statistics and cross-tab. Okay, so once this box appear, okay, you choose your IV and DV. Okay, sorry, you choose the two variables. You can locate either in row or column, depends. Okay, but column basically, we assume it as the DV. Okay, so in this case, we use HAPMA, happy marriage, under rows, and then column is happy general happiness. Okay, then now click statistics. Okay, under statistic, you tick for chi-square, okay, and then pi and Cramer's B. Okay, and then click continue. Okay, and then next, you click for cells. Okay, once you click continue previously, and then you will go to the main, to the home, and then now you choose cell. Okay, under cell display, okay, you choose under the counts here, you choose observe expected. Observe value and then expected value. Okay, under residuals, you choose unstandardized. Okay, for non-integer weights, by default, round cells counts. Okay, so far so good.
Okay.
So then click continue. And then click okay. Okay, so this is your result. Okay. Okay, so for the value residual, okay, for this first table, okay, the expected and observed counts are not the same for happiness of marriage and general happiness. When we refer to the expected value, okay, the expected count, okay, the values are different for all the categories. Okay, for example, this one, very happy, this one, general happiness, very happy, and then this one, happiness of marriage, very happy. So the value, the value for the expected is 370.27. Okay, pretty happy, 436.25. So the values are different. Okay, the residual here indicate the differences between the counts and expected count. Eh? So that's why I highlight on the residual, because the residual will indicate either there are differences in the counts and expected values. Okay. So in this case, it indicates that they are not independent variable. Okay, so meaning that it depend. Not independent, maksudnya it depend. Okay, and then in another word, happiness of marriage and general happiness are related to each other. If you, so based on this descriptive analysis, we can say that once you have a happy, you have a happy marriage, perhaps in general, you are also a happy person. Okay, so based on the chi-square, this is the how you are going to test the hypothesis. Okay, so we refer to the Pearson chi-square value. Okay, Pearson chi-square here. The asymptotic significant indicate that the significant value is 0.000, which is lesser than alpha. Okay, so we reject hash naught. Okay, so we indicate that there is, apa tu, the two variables are related to each other. Okay. Okay, again, then to, apa tu? Okay, so here, this one. One cells or 11.1% have expected count less than 5. So the minimum expected count is 1.98. Okay, so still valid lah. Okay. Okay, so here, one of the 9 3 times 3 cells have an expected frequency less than 5. Too many cells that that has more than 25% is one expected criteria. The overall chi-square value is less likely to be valid. Okay, so if let's say you have more cells that if you have more cells that has expected count less than 5, okay, the tendency to have the invalid result is higher. Okay, but in this case we only have one cells that has the count less than 5, still lesser than 20%. Okay, so the cutoff point is 20%. Okay, so the next one is this one. So we use the Cramer's V value, okay, because this is the 3x3 contingency table, 3x3 because we have 3 level for independent variable, 3 level for dependent variable. So the name is 3x3 contingency table. So for the 3x3 contingency table, we use Cramer's V. Okay, but if for 2x2, we can use pi value, pi coefficient here. So in this case, we refer to the Cramer's V value. So the value is 0.4. Okay, so the value is 0.4. How to interpret this value is, okay, how to interpret this value, okay, similar to how we interpret the R correlation in Pearson product moment correlation and Spearman rank order. Okay, we can use the cutoff point given by Guilford rule of thumb or by Cohen. Okay, to interpret the value. So if we refer to the Guilford rule of thumb, 0.4 indicate weak relationship. Okay, it indicate weak relationship lah between general happiness and happy marriage. Okay. Okay, so this one, so invalid chi-square, if let's say you have the if you have more than 20% cells with expected count less than 5, so we consider your chi-square value is invalid. Okay, meaning that if let's say once you run the analysis and then the notes here indicate that more than 20% cell here have expected count less than 5. Okay, expected count less than 5 ni referring to this table eh. Okay, so if let's say your table here indicate the value less than 5. So in this case only this cell indicate the value less than 5. Okay, in which the cell is negative 4.95, lesser than 5. Okay, regardless of the direction here, for the residual, regardless of the direction, what we want to refer to is only the value. So in our case, only one cell, which is this cell, there is the expected value less than. This one. Okay, we refer to.
That's satu personal.
Betul. This one. Okay, we refer to the expected count here. Okay, so because in this case only one cell that has expected value less than 5, so it is still in overall after we calculate it based on the percentage, it is only 11.1%, which is less than 20%. Okay, so meaning that our chi-square value still valid. Okay. Okay, so but if let's say you have a case which is the cell you have a more than 20% cell with expected count less than 5, okay, we can reduce that by collecting the large sample. Okay, you have more sample size, Okay, it will reduce the tendency to have 20% cells with expected count less than 5. Okay, another another alternative is you can combine data for the smaller expected categories. Okay, so how to do this is actually earlier. Okay, earlier in our example, we have 3 by 3. Okay, but if let's say for example, you have the invalid, chi-square value, meaning that you can combine a few category here. Perhaps from the 3, then you make it as 2. Okay, from the very happy, then you just come up with pretty happy. You just combine between both not happy with pretty happy. So you have 2 by 3 then. Okay, so there is another option. Then you try to run again. Then we see see how is it the note still appear as invalid here. Okay, so this is we have two options. Either you increase the sample size or you just combine the levels too. Okay. Okay, so this is the visual representation. Okay, to display the association between the two variables. Okay, in which the general happiness is taken as column variable, and then the clusters are formed with respect to the categories of row variable. Okay, and then we can see from the bar chart that general happiness is more for the respondents who are happy from the marriage. Okay, this one. Okay, for the very happy, this one, if you have the happy marriage, then in overall you have happy life. Okay. Okay, and then we set our alpha. Okay, so we make decision. So in this case, since our significant chi-square 0.000 lesser than alpha 0.05, therefore we reject hash not. Okay, meaning that there is a significant association between happiness of marriage and general happiness between the two variables. Oh, sorry, ini tu salah tu. Okay, so we can conclude that the two variables, the general happiness and then happiness of marriage, is related to each other. Okay, so earlier, okay, our Cramer's V value is 0.4, right? Okay, so in terms of measure of association, we have three types: pi coefficient, contingency coefficient, and Cramer's V. But earlier, it is based on Cramer's V. Okay, so we use the Guilford rule of thumb to interpret the magnitude of the relationship between variable. Okay, so earlier, because the Cramer's V value equals to 0.4, so it indicate the low relationship according to the Guilford rule of thumb. Okay, you also can use Cohen to interpret the relationship. You just indicate in your write up that it is based on the Cohen. Okay, in terms of APA reporting style, okay, a chi-square test of independence was performed to examine the relation between the relationship between happiness of marriage and general happiness. Okay, so the relationship between these two variables was significant, in which chi-square equals to 424.839, significant value lesser than 0.005. Okay, those meaning that those who have happy marriage tend to have a happy life. Okay, this is the APA table presentation. Okay. Okay. So that's all for today. Any question?
Mm-hmm. Doctor, question.
Yeah, sure.
Okay, just to recap back. So what actually the difference between correlational Pearson correlation and chi square? Because we can see that even chi-square, the purpose of chi-square, we want to check the association between two variables.
Correct.
So, what are the difference, the major difference between chi-square and Pearson correlation?
So, we have three lah. Basically, we have three: Pearson product moment correlation, Spearman rank order correlation, and chi-square test of independence. Okay, in terms of the requirement, when we want to run the Pearson product moment correlation, the IV and DV, in terms of the scale of measurement, it must be either interval or ratio. Okay, the scale of measurement interval or ratio similar to Spearman rank order. Okay, the IV and DV can be interval or ratio or and it is not normal. So therefore, we use Spearman rank order or it is in category. It is in rank order. Okay, it is in it is in ranking order. Okay, ordinal order. Okay, for Spearman rank order ni. Specific requirement is it is based on order. Your data is in order, nominal order, ordinal scale of measurement. Okay, but if let's say you have not normal data, you also can consider Spearman rank order. But for chi-square test of independence, okay, both IV and DV must be in categorical. It cannot be in it cannot be in interval or ratio. It must be in categorical. Okay, you have two variables. You have two categorical variables. So for example, you have one DV. Under that DV, you have three groups. Okay.
Okay.
For your IV, you also have categorical variable. For example, you have two groups. Okay, so this one we call 2 by 3. So the main difference is actually depends on the scale of measurement for our variable. For the categorical variable, for sure we cannot use the Pearson product moment correlation because for the requirement to run the Pearson product moment correlation, the data must meet the requirement of normality. But if let's say you have the categorical variable, then how come you are going to analyze to get the normality test, right? Because the data is categorical. Okay, I guess you will ask me what are the differences between chi-square test of independence and two-way ANOVA. if you ask me that, okay, two-way ANOVA is the DV is based on score, okay, and then the DV is still in continuous data, okay. You just IV, you have ID, you have I few I two IVs that is categorical. But in this case, both IV and DV are in categorical. Okay? And then, in terms of the data also, we do not look at the score. This chi-square test of independence, the data is based on frequency. Okay, how many respondents inside that table? It does not based on score. Okay? Okay, Jim, boleh? Clear?
Boleh lah, insyaAllah.
Okay, any other question?
Doktor.
Ya.
Doktor boleh explainkan lagi sekali tak yang page 38 tu?
Page 38.
Yang output yang ada residual. This one.
Okay. So this one Okay. So this one after we run chi-square test of independence, this is somehow it is the descriptive. So it indicate that how much the count value and expected. Okay, the count value the expected is what we expect. Okay, the count is what has been the count is referring to the observed or the actual situation. Okay, so in this case, the residual value ni, it will indicate the differences between count and expected. Okay, if there is no association, if in general there is no association between happiness of marriage and general happiness ni, the value for both count and expected value will be equal. And then the residual ni will be zero. Okay, faham kat? So far, so good kat situ. Aziz, okay. So, if there is no correlation, there is no association, the residual value here will indicate zero. Okay, meaning that there is no association. Okay, but in this case, okay, the residual, when we refer to the residual value for all the cells, it indicate that the values are different. Okay, so we can say that, okay, the variables are not independent. Not independent. The variables, perhaps the wording here quite confusing. But actually, when we refer, when we rephrase the sentence, actually, if let's say it is not independent, meaning that it is dependent lah. Okay, Zizi. Saya just terbalikkan ni je. Okay, this indicate that they are not independent, meaning that if let's say they are not independent, sama juga dengan ayat, they are related, they are dependent. Okay, Azizi.
Faham, baru faham.
Saya terbalik. Okay, so dalam bahasa, bahasa statistik yang macam tu, bahasa layman dia, dia berkait lah. Okay, so this, this is based on the descriptive lah, but prove it statistically, then we need to refer to the next table.
Okay.
We need to refer to this I-square. Ni, table. So any other question?
Let's start with here. Yeah, yang difference in residual tu, for this one is for goodness of it. What does that mean actually?
Apa tu goodness of it eh?
Goodness of it. Sebab kalau test of independence maksudnya there's association lah between the variables. Tapi kalau goodness of it?
Kalau goodness of it, okay, it is the proportion. Dia lain sikit because in goodness of it there is only one variable. Ada satu. Okay, in goodness of it, there is only one variable. So we want to know either the frequency tu sama tak dengan the expected ni. Okay, wait, I show you. Okay, yang ni siapa yang tanya tadi, nama dia siapa lah?
Faizah.
Okay, Faizah sini. So in chi-square goodness of fit, because there is only one variable, we have only one variable regardless of IVDV. So satu je. Okay, for example, we have we are testing on the level of happiness, the marriage happiness among our respondents. So this is our variable here. Tak kisahlah IV ke DV. Okay. So in this happiness of marriage, we have three categories. Okay. So we have very happy, pretty happy, not happy. Okay, so earlier when we state our null hypothesis, we mentioned that the level of happiness among the respondents are equal. So we want to test either our early assumption is correct or not. Okay, so then after we run the analysis, our result is for observed value is for very happy 855, pretty happy is 445, not too happy 37. So the values are different. Okay, so actually for chi-square goodness of fit, we just compare the frequency inside that variable. Okay, we do not have the second variable. We just look at inside the variable either the proportion of the frequency tu either it is similar or different with our hypothesis. Okay, saya menjawab tak Faizah?
Okay.
Okay, because for chi-square goodness of fit, we have only one IV. We have only one variable, sorry. Regardless of IV or DV, we have only one variable. But meanwhile, for chi-square test of independence, we have two. Okay, we have two categorical variable. Okay, that we look for the association between the variable. Okay?
So for goodness of fit, does difference in residual tu terpakai atau tak?
Okay, dia terpakai. Okay, mana dah result tadi. Okay, so for the residual ni, okay, just compare between the inside level tu, Aiza. Okay, between the observed and expected, between for example, we expect the null hypothesis is equal, right? So equal meaning that the number of sample size we divided by the three categories, so the value is 445.7. So this equal lah. Okay, but after we run the analysis, this is the observed value. The residual is actually indicate the differences between the expected and observed value inside that variable.
Meaning suppose residual was supposed to be zero lah, then baru equally met the hypothesis. Yes. Okay,
understood. No. Kalau zero. Kalau zero, the residual zero, meaning that there is no differences. Faiza, okay. Kalau residual, okay, the residual ni it indicates differences between observed and expected. Okay, based on our earlier time hypothesis, we state that the values are similar, right? Okay, apa punya tu boleh kat saya kejap. Eh, saya sampai sebab saya tak dengar. Okay. Okay, so ambil sapunya ni. Okay, so apa tu, residual ni, again it indicate the differences. Okay, the differences between observed and expected. So earlier based on our null hypothesis, we indicate that the level of happiness between respondents are similar. Okay, so the expected, this is what we expect. Okay, but after we run the the study, okay, we collect the frequency and then we found out that the respondents have a different level of happiness. Okay, so for example, there are 855 respondents indicate that they are very happy. 445 respondents indicate that they are pretty happy. Okay, 337 indicate that they are not too happy. So in which, based on this one, it is totally different from the expected. So that's why we have to reject the null hypothesis. The residual here indicate that if, let's say, the value is zero, meaning that, okay, we fail to reject null hypothesis. Because we fail to show the differences between the observed and expected. Faham, faham Pak Izzah?
Tengah proses.
Okay, macam ni. Saya guna bahasa Melayu boleh? Macam ni.
Boleh.
Okay. The residual ni dia menunjukkan perbezaan apa yang kita jangka dan apa yang kita dapat. Observe ni apa yang kita dapat. Okay.
Okay, faham.
Earlier bila kita kata terdapat null hypothesis kita, kita kata tak ada beza antara responden kita ni. In terms of level of happiness, dia orang level of marriage happiness ni, kebahagiaan berkeluarga ni sama je. Itu null hypothesis kita kan? Okay, so residual ni, okay, kalau let's say kita dapat nilai observe ni sama dengan expected ni. So residual akan jadi kosong, betul?
Betul.
So pada masa yang sama dia akan menunjukkan bahawa tak ada beza lah kan?
Tak ada.
Maksudnya tak ada beza tu sama. Tak ada beza tu maksudnya sama. Betul?
Sama for that kategori lah.
Maksudnya kalau residual kat sini kosong, sini kosong, sini kosong, maksudnya tiada perbezaan antara responden. Dari segi happiness of marriage ni tak ada beza. Tak ada beza maksudnya we fail to reach H0 lah.
Faham.
Tapi in this case, because the residual ni, it indicate that there are differences between observed and expected. So therefore we reject the null hypothesis lah. Faham? The residual ni, it just summarize the value of observed minus expected. If the value is not zero, meaning that there is a differences. Kalau if let's say zero, the value is zero, it indicate there is no differences.
Okay.
Faham dah?
Faham.
So it reflect lah. So in this case, we reject H0 because based on this one, not yet based on the statistical value. We just based on the descriptive ni, we can say that there is a differences between the level of happiness marriage among the respondent. Because bila kita tengok residual value ni, semua bukan kosong. Semalam kita dah tahu significant ke tak, bila value tu significant ke tak, only then we refer to the asymptotic significant ni. Okay.
Okay, alright.
Okay, so any other question?
Doktor, Ruzaimi.
Okay, ya, Ruzaimi.
Betul?
Ya.
Ada possibility tak, Faizah tanya tu, ada possibility tak ada salah satu residual punya value tu dia kosong?
Ada, possible. Possible. For example, into a very happy. Maksudnya, for example macam this one, pretty happy ni, sikit je. So maksudnya in terms of the pretty happy, okay, most of the respondent actually, dia punya in terms of the score of pretty happiness tu lebih kurang sama je. Okay, but there are huge differences in terms of pretty happy and not too happy. So perhaps, okay, we can suggest these two pretty happy table and not too happy ni, the cell ni we can combine untuk tengok mungkin the result lagi significant ke. Tapi dia memang ada possibility yang they observe the residuals ni equals to zero. There's a possibility.
Okay, and then kalau macam tu kita fail to reject lah kan? It's not.
No, because the hypothesis testing, Sorry. The hypothesis testing still based on this one, Ruzaimi. Still based on asymptotic significance ni. This one, okay, for the happiness frequency ni, it just the descriptive je dulu. Okay, the roughly. So nanti kena tengok sama ada reject ke tak, depend on this one. Okay, significant value ni.
Okay,
boleh.
Okay. Doktor lagi, kalau refer to Guilford rules of thumb tu, kalau kita dapat value exactly 0.4, that means kita kena follow, kita kena refer pada yang low ataupun moderate.
Again, Zaimi saya tak dengar. Sorry, sekali lagi.
Okay. Kalau kita refer pada Guilford rule of thumb tu, okay, table tu, kalau exactly value tu kita dapat 0.4, kita akan ambil yang low punya ni ke ataupun moderate?
Kan, you all ni cekedik lah kan. Okay lah, actually macam gini. Apa tu, biasanya kita pakai kalau macam contoh less than 2. Biasanya yang nombor 2, macam contoh kita pakai scale less than 2. Kalau less than 2 tu, kita panggil negligible. 2 hingga 4 kan, 2 hingga 4 kita panggil low. Okay, 4 and 6 moderate. Okay, so basically, okay, you can consider untuk guna sebagai moderate. Faham? Maksudnya yang tu between 2.4 tu dia boleh jadi between 2.39999. Okay, maknanya below 4. Below 4. So 4 tu
below 4 lah, below 4.
Below 4. Okay, so 4 tu yang the next level tu 4 to 6 tu baru kita panggil moderate. The third level. Lagi okay lah. Okay. Okay, Ajin dah hanggut dah tu. Okay. Okay, so if there is no more question, okay, I thought we stop here. Okay, unless you want to proceed with you want me to proceed with ya Allah, but mediation analysis. Sikit lah saya bagi mukadimah mediation lah.
Doktor, yang ni dah ada lecture note ke?
Belum.
Ada. Lecture note ada. Saya tengah update.
Okay.
Tengah update tu, Doktor. Next week lah, next class lah kita continue.
Lucu. Okay, so by the way lah, before next class sikit je. Because actually when we want to run the mediation, we need to install extra software. So perhaps you at least dah prepare lah dengan software tu. Mungkin saya tunjuk sikit macam mana nak install je. Nak install je. Okay, saya takkan masuk untuk analisis, tapi macam mana nak install sahaja. Sekejap eh, secara. Sebab moderation dah siap, nanti saya share. Sebab saya memang suka update lecture note saya. Supaya, yelah macam tu lah, orang tengah belajar lagi kan. So saya still update daripada sem lepas. Supaya lagi senang untuk difahami. Share yang mediation dulu ni. But this one you need to download daripada external sources, so at least bila dah tu senang sikit lah. Sebab nak menginstall ni renyah juga. Cari mana dah. Okay, apa slide ni? Okay, before we run, tapi yang ni saya tunjuk slide moderation, but step dia sama juga nanti. Okay, before we, our lecture will be next 2 weeks actually, because next week we are not going to have the lecture because saya dah apply cuti dah balik kampung. Okay, so please go to this website eh. Saya share dekat, ni lah saya share dekat. Saya share dekat chat ni. Saya share dekat chat. Oh tak boleh buat ni. Okay, saya share dekat chat. Okay, please go to this website. Kat chat eh. Okay, download this download this file. Because to run the mediation, we need the external external supported software to make our life easier. Kalau tak payah sikit lah, kalau tak ada software ni. Okay, this software has been developed by Hayes. Okay, Andrew A Hayes, Andrew F Hayes. Okay, bagus aja. Okay, please follow. Please download the file according to your computer system. If you use Mac, iOS, then please choose for iOS. Then if let's say you use Windows, then you choose for Windows. Okay, dah pergi dah buka website ni, dah download dah. Okay, so after you download, ni nak terang hak ni. Okay, once you download saya tunjuk dekat ni lah. Saya punya IBM SPSS. Pesan buka IBM SPSS pun punya lama. Okay, so once you download that zip file, okay, make sure you extract that document, and locate that document onto your desktop. Lagi senang, okay. After you download the zip file, okay, then you extract the document tu and then locate on your desktop. Lagi or any place that is easier for you to find later, okay. Then okay, dah extract? You already extracted the file?
Yeah.
Okay, so once done, okay, you open your IBM SPSS. Okay, open your IBM SPSS. Okay, and then now, semua boleh nampak saya punya screen ni kan? Nampak kan? Nampak tak saya punya screen ni, Azizi?
Nampak.
Okay, so pergi dekat.
Nampak.
Okay, so go to your dataset. Okay, now you click file. Click open. File, open and syntax. Oh, tak nak gerak dah ni. Click file, click open, click syntax. Okay. Chat. So once this box appear, nampak eh box ni eh? Yang keluar ni eh? So you choose, pergi dekat, go to the folder that you save, that you extracted earlier, the extracted folder. Okay, for example, in my case, I extract it as, mana dah proses tadi? This one. So, so I... Yeah. Siapa? Azizi ke? Siapa? Okay. Okay. Go to the extracted file here and then choose process. Process.sps. Choose this one. Okay. And then click open. Okay. Once done. Okay. You will see the process, you will see this syntax editor. Okay, you can see and then scroll down and then you can see the process activate equals to 1 minute. You already successfully install the software. Okay, done. We have another step, sabar. Okay, now when you go to your analyze regression, okay, there is no any additional tab, right? You go to analyze regression tab, analyze regression on your right side too, there is no additional tab, right? Ada kan? So we need to add that tab on your list of analysis too. Okay, to do that, now you click extension, click utilities, extension, utilities, and then click install custom dialog. Okay, extensions, utilities, and install custom dialog. You click this one. Okay, so this box appear, this new one. Okay, now again, go to your data set. Go to the extracted file. Okay, go to the extracted file. Okay, and then you click this one, custom dialog builder file. You click this one. Okay, and then you choose process.spd. You choose this one. Okay, so you click open. Okay, so actually for me, I've already installed. For you, you just click okay. So for my case, because I already installed. So for your case, you just click, because there will be notification appear, right?
Yeah.
So for mine, cancel. So to check either it is success or not, you can go to analyze, and then click regression, and then now you can see this new one. Process version 3.5 by Andrew F. Hayes. Got it? Semua dapat?
Dapat.
Alhamdulillah. So this is the one lah. Later we will go, we will use this one to run the mediator and moderation analysis. Okay? Nah, itu je lah untuk for today. Okay, so that's all. If there is no more question, so we should stop here lah. Tak ada soalan lah kan? Okay, by the way, tak apalah. Tak payah. Tadi Faizah dah tanya kot. Okay, tak ada soalan eh? Apa tu Ruzaimi ha dah pergi tu potong rambut tu.
Okey.
Tak pakai cakap.
Tak boleh. Tak boleh buat bincang ni.
Baru dah nak cakap baru.
Okay, so dah kalau dah tak ada soalan, so we stop here lah eh. So next week I wish you good luck, all the best for going to submit your dissertation. Okay. So that's all for today guys. Thank you. Stay safe ya.
Okay. Thank you, Radha.
Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.